Hello, good evening. Last class, we were discussing about direction ratios and direction cosines. I gave some results under that. I told you, let me revise. X, Y, Z, three axes mutually perpendicular to each other. PQ is any line in space. Throughout, draw a line OA parallel to PQ, which makes an angle alpha with x-axis, first direction of x-axis, beta, first direction of y-axis, gamma, first direction of z-axis. Alpha, beta, gamma are the inclinations of OA with x-axis, y-axis, z-axis. Then, cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma. Cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma are called direction cosines, are called direction cosines of PQ, direction cosines of OA, direction cosines of PQ. We can also say cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma are the direction cosines of OA also. Okay. Now, this is the direction cosines will always satisfy, cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to 1. All, that is any line, if you take direction cosines, they will satisfy cos square alpha, cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to 1. That's why I told you for x-axis direction cosines are 100, because angle between x-axis and x-axis is 90 minus 0, cos 0 is 1, angle between x-axis and y-axis is 90, get cos 90 0. Angle between x-axis and z-axis is 90, cos 90 0. 100 are the direction cosines of x-axis, 010 are the direction cosines of y-axis, 001 are the direction cosines of z-axis. If this satisfies the condition, 1 square, 0 square, 0 square is 1. So this condition is satisfied. Okay. Now, having seen direction cosines, we have solved some simple problems under direction cosines, direction ratios. If cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma, if cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma are the direction cosines of any line in space, you take three numbers proportional to that. ABC are proportional to cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma. Then ABC are called the direction ratios. And A square plus B square is not equal to, A square plus B square plus C square is not equal to 1. Whereas cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is 1. If ABC are the direction ratios proportional to direction cosines, A square plus B square plus C square is not equal to 1. Okay. So we have seen some problems under this. We can solve some more problems. Before that, let us see some results. Let us see some standard results based on direction ratios and direction cosines. Angle between two lines whose direction ratios are A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2. Angle between two lines whose direction ratios are A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2. If theta is the angle between two lines in space, then cos theta, is given by the formula A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 whole divided by square root of A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square, square root of A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square. So this is the formula to find the angle between two lines whose direction ratios are given. In particular, when the lines are perpendicular, to each other, theta is 90, cos 90, cos 90 is 0, cross multiply, we give the condition A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 is equal to 0. That means, A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 is equal to 0. This is called the inner product. a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2 is equal to 0. This a1 a2 b1 b2 c1 c2 is called inner product. If the inner product is 0, then automatically we say the two lines are perpendicular to each other. Two lines are perpendicular to each other. So therefore in space, whenever two lines are perpendicular, two lines are perpendicular. This condition is necessarily satisfied. Okay. On the contrary, if the lines are parallel, if the lines are parallel with the direction ratios a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2, lines are parallel, then automatically two lines are parallel with the direction ratios a1, b1, c1, direction ratios a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2, it satisfies the relation a1 by a2 is equal to b1. This can be derived. This can be derived easily. C1 by C2. These three ratios are equal. That means they are proportional. Direction ratios are proportional. We come to a conclusion the lines are parallel. Lines are parallel. For example, if 1, 2, 2 are the direction ratios of one line, 2, 4, 4 are the direction ratios of another line, automatically they are parallel. Or we can also say minus 1, minus 2, minus 2. They are the direction ratios of another line. All these lines are parallel. All these lines are parallel. So whenever lines are parallel, direction ratios are proportional. The lines are perpendicular. The inner product is 0. Inner product means a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2 is equal to 0. This is right. Now, instead of direction ratios, direction cosines are given. L1 m1 n1, L2 m2 n2, L2 m2 n2. Or the direction cosines of two lines, direction cosines of two lines, and theta is the angle between the line, then cos theta is given by the formula L1 L2 plus M1 M2 plus N1 N2 is equal to 0. So this is the formula to find angle between two lines when direction cosines are given. Direction cosines means L1 square plus M1 square plus N1 square is equal to 1, L2 square plus M2 square plus N2 square is equal to 1. So therefore, automatically cos theta angle between them is given by this formula. Here also, when the lines are perpendicular, cos 90 is 0. Therefore, again, inner product L1 L2 M1 M2 plus N1 N2 is equal to 0. If L1 L2 plus M1 M2 plus N1 N2 is equal to 0, we simply come to a conclusion that two lines are parallel. If the lines are parallel, then L1 is equal to L2, M1 is equal to M2, N1 is equal to N2. No question of proportionality. Exactly equal. L1 is equal to L2, M1 is equal. Exactly it should coincide. L1 is equal to M2, L2, M1 is equal to M2, N1 is equal to N2. If this condition is satisfied, they are parallel. If this condition is satisfied, we say they are perpendicular. Okay. Now, the two lines need not meet each other. In spite of that, we can find the angle between them. In space, you can see there are many lines, they don't meet each other. In spite of that, we can find the angle between them. We can easily find the angle between them. Okay. Now, there is one result, third result. That result is, this is some line in space with the direction cosines LMN. LMN gives the direction cosines of some line in space. P and Q are two points. P coordinates x1, y1, z1. Q, x2, y2, z2. x1, y1, z1, x2, y2, z2 are the coordinates of two points, P and Q. From P, you can draw a line perpendicular to this line with the direction cosines LMN. We can draw a line perpendicular LQM, PL are perpendiculars drawn from P and Q to a line whose direction cosines are given. Now, once the perpendiculars are drawn, this LM is nothing but projection. This LM is called projection. Projection of the line joining, projection of PQ. Projection of PQ on a line whose direction cosines are LMN. So PQ, some line in space, any line, it can be in any direction. draw perpendiculars from P and Q. This LM is called projection of PQ on a line whose direction cosines are LM here. That projected length is given by the formula x2 minus x1 into L. This is very important result. Y2 minus y1 into M. Y2 minus y1 into M. Plus z2 minus z1 into L. Z2 minus z1 into L. So x2 minus x1 into L. Y2 minus y1 into M. Z2 minus z1 into. Even if you take x1 minus x2 into L, y1 minus y2 into M, z1 minus z2 into L. The projection length cannot be negative. Even if we get negative, we take absolute value and say it is positive and say this is the projection of line joining two given points on a line whose direction cosines are given. So that is given by the formula x2 minus x1 into L, y2 minus y1 into M plus z2 minus z1 into L. So this is a formula to find the projected length. If the projected length happens to be zero, suppose a line is here, another line is here, PQ is here, in fact PQ is perpendicular to, PQ is perpendicular to the line, then automatically if you find a perpendicular, if you draw perpendiculars from P and Q, foot of the perpendicular will be the same. In that case, projected length is zero. So whenever projected length is zero, the conclusion is PQ is perpendicular to your line, PQ is perpendicular to LM, you can say, or PQ is perpendicular to a line whose direction cosines are LMN. You can say like that. So therefore, once the projected length happens to be zero, we come to a conclusion, the line PQ is perpendicular to a line whose direction cosines LMN. Okay. Now based on these results, we can solve some standard problems. Let us take some other problems. Before that, let us take this problem first. Yes. Let us take example number 4 first. We are finding the angle between two diagonals of a cube. We are finding the angle between any two diagonals. First of all, we have drawn a cube. After drawing a cube, we are fixing O at one corner as origin, 0, 0, 0. You take this line as x-axis, this horizontal line. This line which is perpendicular, this is called y-axis and this is called z-axis. We are fixing three edges as three axes, x-axis, y-axis, z-axis. Certainly, suppose if A happens to be the edge of a cube, the OA, this is A, therefore A is on the x-axis, the coordinates of A are A0, 0, 0. The coordinates of A are A0, 0, 0. Now, you come to this XOY plane, B is a point on the XOY plane, automatically height is 0, and from this, if you draw a line parallel to this, it cuts x-axis at A, therefore automatically this is A, this is A, this is A. Hence, coordinates of B are A, A, 0. Coordinates of B are A, A, 0. Because it is on XOY plane, for all points on XOY plane, height is 0. Height is represented by Z coordinate. Therefore, A, A, 0. X coordinate is A, Y coordinate is B. Distance measured parallel to X axis, distance measured parallel to Y axis. Now, you take C. From C, if you draw a line perpendicular, this is the foot of the perpendicular. From this, you draw a line parallel to y-axis. It cuts x-axis at A. This is A. This is A. This is A. Therefore, coordinates of C are A, A, A. So, we get the coordinates of C as C. Our last class, we have discussed this. But anyhow, we are discussing by taking as a cube. Similarly, you take D. D is a point on XOZ plane. XOZ plane, y-coordinate is absent. So, 0 here. X-coordinate is A. Z coordinate is A, A, 0, A gives coordinates of D. E is a point on Z axis. For all points on the Z axis, X coordinate is 0, Y coordinate is 0, Z coordinate is only this distance. That is nothing but the height of the cube. That is also, since it is a cube, it is A. Therefore, edge is A. Therefore, this is A. 0, 0, A gives coordinates of E. F is a point on Y, O, Z plane. F is a point on YOZ plane. For all points on this plane, there is no distance measured parallel to X axis. Therefore, X coordinate is 0, you get automatically for this point, if you draw perpendicular and draw along y axis, you cut x axis at O. Where this is A, this is A. Therefore, x coordinate is 0, y coordinate is A, y coordinate is this, z coordinate is A. 0, A, A. And automatically, y is a point on the y axis, 0, A, 0. So, 0, 0, 0, A, 0, 0, A, A, 0, A, 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 0, A, 0, 0, A, 0, A, A, 0, A, 0 are the coordinates of the vertices of a cube, vertices of a cube. Once you know all the vertices, first of all you must know how many diagonals are there, how many diagonals are there for a cube. Now, this CD is not a diagonal. EA is not a diagonal. EA is a diagonal for that surface. And OC is one diagonal. OC is one diagonal. Line joining origin and C is one diagonal. BE is another diagonal. BE is another diagonal. So OEC and BE are two diagonals. AF is one diagonal. AF is one diagonal. And AD is another diagonal. AD is another. So we are having only four diagonals. Well, they are OC, BE, AF, and AD, this is FG. This must be G, GD. Sorry. You call this as G. So this is G. This is not A. Sorry. This is G. GD is another diagonal. OC, one diagonal. BE, one diagonal. AF, one diagonal. GD, another diagonal. To find the angle between any two diagonals, you can take any two. I am taking OE and OC and BE, OC and BE. First of all, let us take direction ratios of OC. Whenever two points are known, two coordinates are known, the direction ratios are given by difference between x coordinates, difference between y coordinates, difference between z coordinates. A minus 0, A. A minus 0, A. A minus 0, A. So therefore, A are the direction ratios of OC. Direction ratios of OC. If you want, you can find direction cosines. Not necessarily. We have formula. Even with the direction ratios, you can find angle between two lines. Even direction cosines, you can find angle between two lines. Let us take direction ratios. So similarly, let us find the direction ratios of BE. Let us find the direction ratios of BE. BE. Direction ratios A minus 0, A. A minus 0, A. 0 minus A minus A. Therefore, we are having two lines with us with the direction ratios. With the direction ratios A. Direction ratios of OC. A minus A. Direction ratios of B. These are the direction ratios of two lines. Direction ratios of two lines. They are nothing but a diagonals, two diagonals of a cube. Therefore, cos theta. If theta is the angle between two diagonals, angle between two diagonals of a cube, that cos theta is given by A square plus A square minus A square divided by, I'll write it here. Right, A, direction ratios of OC, and A minus A, direction ratios of BE, then angle between them is theta, cos theta is A square plus A square minus A square divided by square root of A square plus A square plus A square, the square root of A square A square minus A whole square again A square. So we get A square divided by 3A square inside square root. You got A square root 3, you get 3. Here you get, by taking A square out, A here by taking a square root get a 1 plus 1 root 3 root 3 3. So you get 1 by 3. Therefore theta is equal to cos inverse 1 by 3. So this is the angle between any two diagonals. Even if you take other two diagonals, I have given other two diagonals. Even if you take other two diagonals, find angle, you get a very same thing, cos inverse 1 by 3. So even if you take out of four diagonals, if any two are taken, angle between them is observed as cos inverse 1 by 3. So this is the angle between, it's a fixed result, irrespective of the edge, can be AAA or BBB, whatever it may be. So therefore automatically we can take the edge as 1, 1, 1. So length is 1, breadth is 1, height is 1. So even then, angle between any two diagonals will be cos inverse 1 by 3. It is independent of the length of edge, cos inverse 1 by 3. Okay, now we will take another problem. It's a very interesting problem. It's an IIT question. It's an IIT problem. Very, very interesting, very easy also. It is based on the condition. If a line has got direction cosines LMN, then L square plus M square plus N square is equal to 1. This is problem is based on that result. Any line in space makes alpha, beta, gamma, delta with the four diagonals of a cube. We know diagonals. So A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Diagonals are OC, one diagonal, BE, another diagonal, GD, one diagonal, AF. There are four diagonals. Alpha is the angle between any line. You call that line as PQ. You need not draw horizontal any line, some line in space. It makes alpha with OC, one diagonal, beta with other diagonal, that is other diagonal BE, gamma with GD, delta with AF. So a line PQ makes alpha with OC, that means we can write like this, a line PQ, angle between PQ and OC is alpha. PQ makes alpha with OC, one diagonal. That line PQ, you take another diagonal BE, angle between that line in PQ is beta. The angle between some line in space with GD is gamma. The angle between PQ with AF is delta. That means the line PQ makes alpha with OC, beta with BE, gamma with GD, delta with AF. A line PQ makes alpha, beta, gamma, delta with the four diagonals of a cube. Find a cos square alpha, cos square beta, cos square gamma, cos square delta. Show that it is equal to 4 by 3. Show that it is equal to 4 by 3. Very, very simple. Only thing is, we can assume, first of all, the line PQ has direction cosines LMN. First of all, we are assuming the line PQ has got direction cosines LMN. We are assuming the direction cosines as LMN. LMN stands for direction cosines of PQ. First assumption. I'm like LM. That is automatically L square plus M square plus N square is equal to 1. That is implied. OC is one diagonal with the direction ratios. We have seen that in the previous problem. That's why I have taken that problem in the beginning. OC is one diagonal with the direction ratios AAA, because A minus 0, A minus 0, A minus 0. We can find a direction cosines from AAA. Once you know AAA as direction ratios, we can take A square, A square, A square. You get 3A square. That is A root 3. That is root 3A. Divide by that, you get A by A root 3. You get 1 by root 3. You get 1 by root 3. 1 by root 3, 1 by root 3, 1 by root 3. This gives direction cosines of OC. So direction cosines of OC are 1 by root 3, 1 by root 3, 1 by root 3. How it is obtained? From direction ratios, you divide by square root of a square plus a square plus a square, you get a root 3, divide by a root 3, a root 3, a root 3. You get 1 by root 3, 1 by root 3, 1 by root 3. So therefore, is 1 by root 3, 1 by root 3, 1 by root 3 are the direction cosines of what diagonal? LMN are the direction cosines of that line PQ, of the line P. Angle between them is given as alpha. Alpha is the angle between these two lines. Therefore, you apply the formula for cos alpha. I told you when the direction cosines are given, L1, L2, M1, M2 plus N1, N2. You find the inner product, that will do. So, L by root 3 plus M by root 3. And then I am finding the inner product. First component, second component, third component. You find a product, that is called inner product. L by root 3, M by root 3 plus N by root 3. This gives inner product. Therefore, cos alpha is given by this formula. If alpha is the angle between line PQ and one diagonal. Similarly, cos beta will be 1 by root, is L by root 3, this is not 1, this is L by root 3, M by root 3 minus N by root 3. And cos gamma you find L by root 3 minus M by root 3 plus N by root 3. Here negative here, negative here. Here, negative here. Cos delta will be this. You can easily verify after finding directional cosines of BE, GD, AF. Find the inner product. You get the cos beta is this, cos gamma is this, cos delta is this. Cos square alpha, square this. Cos square beta, square this. Cos square gamma, square this. Cos square delta, square this. So, cos square alpha, squaring 1 by root 3 is common, 1 by root 3 is common, it is taken out. 1 by root 3 square is 1 by 3, L square plus N square plus N square. 2LN, 2MN, 2LN, all the terms are positive. Whereas squaring this, again you get 1 by 3, L square plus N square plus N square, minus 2LN, minus 2MN plus 2LN. Two terms are negative, one term is positive. Here also two terms will be negative, one term will be positive. Here also it is like that. Adding all squares. Many terms will cancel, leaving only these three terms. 4L square, because here one L square, L square, L square, 4L square, 4 is taken out. M square, 4M square. N square, 4N square. LM, minus 2LM, all LM terms, MN terms, LN terms gets cancelled, giving only 4 by 3, L square plus M square plus M square. Which L square plus M square plus M square is 1, because they are representing direction cosines of a line. Therefore, we are left with only 4 by 3. This happens to be 1. We are getting 4 by 3. It's a very interesting problem. Only thing is, you must know this result, that's all. Once you know that result, L square plus M square plus N square is 1. We are getting the result cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma plus cos square delta is equal to 4 by 3. Now, this is another IIT problem. And many competitive examination, they ask this problem. Many competitive examination, they ask this problem. Direction cosines of the bisectors of the angles between, angles means internal bisector and external bisector, acute angle and obtuse angle. Direction cosines of the bisectors are the angles between the lines whose direction cosines are L1, M1, N1 and L2, M2, N2. We are interested in finding the direction cosines of the bisectors of the angle between two lines whose direction cosines are L1, M1, N1, L2, M2, N2. Yes. First of all, you can find one simple result. It is there. For a line, I will just mention that result. between that place. And O is the origin. P is any point. If L, M, N are the direction cosines of this line, then automatically we can call this point as coordinates L, M, N, provided this distance is 1. If you take a point at 1 unit distance from origin, direction cosines L, M, N, then coordinates of that point are L, M, N. Similarly, you take a point Q, your L1, M1, N1 are the direction cosines of this line. The distance is 1 unit, then coordinates of Q can be taken as L1, M1, N1. Because you find the distance, automatically root of L1 square, M1 square, N1 square, that will be 1. So therefore, it's a result. We are making use of that result. O is the origin. O is the origin, 0, 0, 0. L1, M1, N1 are the direction cosines of one line. L2, M2, N2 are the direction cosines of this line. You call this point as P, this point as Q. Theta is the angle between them, that is called acute angle. So whenever two lines intersect, we are having acute angle between the two lines. We are also having obtuse angle between the two lines. One theta and 180 minus theta. We have both. Whenever we say angle between the two lines, you can give either acute angle or obtuse angle. Once you give acute angle theta, and automatically obtuse angle is 180 minus theta. Once you give the obtuse angle as phi, the acute angle will be 180 minus phi, like that. So therefore, if theta is the acute angle, 180 minus theta is the obtuse angle. Now 30, 150, like that. Now 60, 120, like that. Then, if theta is acute angle, this bisector will be internal bisector. 180 minus theta is the obtuse angle. This bisector, bisecting this angle, will be external bisector. So for whenever two lines meet and intersect, we are having internal bisector and external bisector. Therefore, we want the direction cosines of the bisectors. We want direction cosines of both the bisectors, internal bisector as well as external bisector. Okay. The lines are having direction cosines L1, M1, N1, L2, M2, N2. Conveniently, we have taken a point P with the coordinates L1, M1, N1, L2, M2, N2. Then you can take a midpoint. You can take a midpoint of that. Midpoint will be L1 plus L2 by 2. Last we have seen M1 plus M2 by 2. Average between X coordinates, Y coordinates, Z coordinates gives the coordinates of the midpoint. Then once you know the midpoint, automatically join this, that gives automatically internal bisector. Automatically internal bisector. So now L1 plus L2, M1 plus M2, L1 plus N1 plus N2, they are proportional to this, because if you divide by 2, you get this. Therefore, they are called the direction ratios. So therefore, the direction ratios of one bisector will be L1 plus L2, M1 plus M2, N1 plus N2. And similarly, direction ratios of the external bisectors are L1 minus L2, M1 minus M2, N1 minus M2. Therefore, these two are the direction ratios, are direction ratios of internal bisector and external bisector. If you want direction cosines, what will you do? You square root of this square, divide by that. Similarly, square root of this square, divide by that, you get direction cosines. So therefore, once you know direction ratios, we can find the direction cosines. Okay. It's a very, very important problem. Very, very important problem for all competitive examination, in particular for IIT joint entrance examination. It's very important for joint entrance examination. Show that the problem, go through the problem 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, any number of times. Understand the problem first. Show that the straight lines whose direction cosines are given by 2L minus M plus 2N is equal to 0, LM plus MN plus NL is equal to 0 are at right angles. That is, the straight lines two straight lines. The two straight lines with the direction cosines satisfying this relation and this relation. That is, if you take two lines AB and AC with the direction cosines L1, M1, N1 of one line, L2, M2, N2 of another line, underline, both the direction cosines satisfies both the relations. That is very important to understand. Two lines whose direction cosines satisfies 2L minus M plus 2N is equal to 0, LM plus MN plus NL is equal to 0, show that these two lines are at right angles. Show that these two lines are at right angles. If the direction cosine satisfies 2L minus M plus 2N is equal to 0, LM plus MN plus NL is equal to 0, then they are at angles. Don't be under the impression L1, M1 satisfies the first relation, L2, M2, N2 satisfies second relation. Not like that. Both the lines satisfies both the relations. That is understanding here. Both the lines satisfies both the relations. That means first condition is 2L minus M plus 2N is equal to 0. This L1, M1, N1 satisfies that. That means 2L1 minus M1 plus 2N1 is equal to 0. L2, M2, N2 also satisfies that. That is 2L2 minus M2 plus 2N2 is equal to 0. Then second relation is LM plus MN plus NL is equal to 0. You take first direction cosines. Direction cosines is the first line L1, M1, N1. L1, M1, M1, N1, N1, L1 is equal to 0. L2, M2, N2 also satisfies, that is L2, M2, M2, N2, N2, L2 is equal to 0. Both the direction cosine satisfies both the relations. Show that the angle between the lines is 90 degrees. That's a problem. You can understand the problem, but solving and getting the two direction cosines a bit difficult. Not that much difficult. Very simple. Once you follow in a systematic way, there are many problems like this, many problems like this, you can easily understand and solve. Let us see how it is solved. That solving the problem based on solving of equations, solving of two equations. Let us take two equations first. Let us take two equations first. First equation is 2L minus M plus 2N is equal to 0. From this, M is equal to, this term carries negative sign, I am bringing it to that side, M is equal to 2 times L plus N. Substituting this, I am substituting this relation, I am taking M from this, I am substituting in the second relation. This is first relation, this is second relation, I am substituting in the second relation. L, M, in the place of M, write 2 times L plus N. 2 times L plus N. Already L is there. This is L. This is L. In the place of M, I am writing 2 times L plus N. In the place of M, I am writing 2 times L plus N. N is there as such. NL. 2L square plus 2L square. Okay. Plus 4LN. Why 4LN? Only 2LN. Yes, 2L into, that is L into, L is 2 times, L is, okay, it is like this, already 2 is out, okay, 2LN plus 2LN, okay, yes, so this on simplification, yeah, let us take like this, 2L square plus 2LN, you get 2LN, here you get 1LN, that is 4LN, plus NL, NL, 2N square plus NL. This NL is here, this 2N square. Terms are displaced, that's all. So ultimately, 2L square, 5LN plus 2N square is equal to 0. By eliminating M from this equation, we get 2L square, 5LN plus 2N square is 0. Factorize, we get L plus 2N, 2L plus N. That is 2L plus N. L plus 2N. We are getting two factors. We are getting two factors for this. Equate that to 0. I repeat again. eliminate M, take M from the first equation, substitute in the second equation, we get this relation. On eliminating M, we get 2L square 5LN plus 2L square is equal to 0. Take M from this, substitute here, you get this. Factorize, you get this. We are getting two factors. For each factor, you get one solution. By taking first factor, find LMN, we get direction cosines of first line. You take second factor, find LMN, you get direction cosines of second line. That is the methodology here. That's the methodology. First, I am taking 2L plus N is equal to 0. 2L plus N is equal to 0. 2L is equal to minus N. L by minus 1 is equal to N by 2. Bring 2 here, bring minus 1 here. L by minus 1 is equal to N by 2. These two are equal. Each is equal to lambda. I am equating each to lambda. Therefore, L is equal to minus lambda. Cross multiply. N is equal to 2 lambda. Substituting in the relation, M is equal to 2L plus 2N. Substituting for M, 2 lambda, that is, I am substituting in this relation. M is equal to 2L plus 2N. 2L plus 2N. I am substituting here. 2L plus 2M. M is equal to 2L plus 2N. 2L is minus 2 lambda. 2N is 4 lambda. You get 2 lambda. M by 2 is equal to lambda. I am equating everything to lambda. L by minus 1 is lambda. N by 2 is lambda. M by 2 is lambda. L by minus 1 is lambda, M by 2 is lambda, N by 2 is lambda. I am converting everything in terms of lambda. Why? Because if you write like this, automatically the denominators gives us a direction ratios. Denominators gives us proportional values. Therefore, minus 1, 2, 2 are the direction ratios of the first line. Direction ratios of the first line. Convert to direction cosines, root of 1 square, 2 square, 2 square, 3, minus 1 by 3, 2 by 3, 2 by 3, are the direction cosines of the first line. After finding this, you can easily verify whether it satisfies the first condition as well as second condition. Automatically, it will satisfy. Therefore, similarly, by similar procedure, in the sense, take L plus 2N is equal to 0, L plus 2L is 0. L is equal to minus 2N. L is equal to minus 2N. L is equal to minus 2N. L by minus 2 is equal to N by 1. Each is equal to lambda. Substitute for L and N. Get M. And convert everything in terms of lambda. You get automatically, minus 2 by 3, minus 2 by 3, 1 by 3, or the direction cosines of second line, We have obtained direction cosines of first line, L1, M1, N1, direction cosines of second line, L2, M2, N2. Once you know two lines with direction cosines, angle between them can be obtained by a formula. Cos theta, this also solved here. L plus 2n is equal to 0, L is equal to minus 2n, L by minus 2 is equal to m by n by 1. Therefore, ultimately, L by minus 2, n by 1 is lambda. Substituting that m, you get m is equal to 2l plus 2n, substituting at minus 2 lambda. L by minus 2 is lambda, m by minus 2 is lambda, n by 1 is lambda. Therefore, minus 2, minus 2, 1. Are the direction ratios, direction cosines are minus 2 by 3, minus 2 by 3, 1 by 3. Now, once you know direction cosines of two lines, you find the inner product, L1, L2, M1, M2, N1, N2. That is here, L1, L2, M1, M2, N1, N2. Minus 1 by 3, 2 by 3, you get 2 by 9, minus 4 by 9, and 2 by 9. So simplifying this automatically, so you get 2 by 9 minus 4 by 9, 2 by 9. You get exactly 0, it cancels each other, giving 0. Once the inner product is 0, conclusion is they are at right angles. So we can easily say the angle between the disc areas. This is a very important kind of solving. Very important. You just go through this two times, three times. Many problems are there in computer examination question paper. You try to understand also. Sometimes they may ask angle between them is 120 degrees, angle between them is 60 degrees, angle between them is 45 degrees, like that. So, all only thing is, once you are in a position to find direction cosine satisfying both the relations, automatically the problem can be solved. It's a very interesting problem. Okay. Now, with this, we come to a conclusion of the fundamental chapter. With this we go to a plane, and before that you must know what is a plane. We are starting plane now in three dimension. After completing the fundamentals, all fundamentals, we are going to plane. What's a plane? Now, this is a surface. This is called a curved surface. This is called a curved surface. We call this as curved surface. I have drawn a curved surface in a plane surface. In a plane surface. Join two points. Joining P and Q, this point and this particular point. Automatically, this will not lie on the surface. This will not lie on the surface. The condition is, if the line joining any two points on a surface lies on the surface itself, that surface is called a plane. I will give the definition. If the line joining is the line joining any two points. The line joining any two points on a surface lies on the surface itself. Lies on the surface itself. Then that surface is called, that surface is called a plane. If the line joining any two points on a surface lies on the surface itself, lies on the surface itself, then that surface is called a plane. Now, first of all, suppose, let us take two dimensions. A is a point x1, y1. B is a point x2, y2. How to get coordinates of all points in between A and B? That's a question. I am finding the coordinates of all points in between A and B on the line itself. Suppose I am getting this point. I am getting this point, I am getting this point, I am getting this point. How is it possible? Methodology is, you take lambda times x1, y1 plus 1 minus lambda times x2, y2. This particular point is very important for computer examination. Many problems can be solved based on this concept. Lambda times x1, y1 plus 1 minus lambda times x2, y2. When lambda lies between 0 and 1, when lambda lies between 0 and 1, including 0 and 1, this gives all points in between A and B for different values of lambda. In particular, when lambda is 0, you get this point. When lambda is 1, you get this point. When lambda lies between 0 and 1, you get a point in between A and B. Provided lambda lies between 0 and 1. That is very important. That is very, very important. So therefore, if the line joining x1 y1 x2 y2. To get any point on that, we make use of the formula lambda times x1 y1 1 minus lambda times x2 y2. Allow lambda to vary from 0 to 1. Allow lambda to vary. You get almost all points. You can get any point in between. This is extended in 3 dimension, 4 dimension, n dimension also. That means if A is a point, x1, y1, z1 in 3 dimension, B is a point, x2, y2, z2, x2, y2, z2. You can get a coordinates of almost all points on this line. You can get a coordinate of almost all points on the line by varying lambda. x1, y1, lambda times x1, y1, z1. Plus 1 minus lambda times x2, y2, z2. 1 minus lambda times x2, y2, z2. Allow lambda to vary from 0 to 1. Allow lambda to vary from 0 to 1. Lambda is half, you get a point, midpoint. Lambda is 1 by 3, you get 1 point of trisection. When lambda is 2 by 3, another point of trisection. Lambda is 1 by 5, lambda is 2 by 5, 3 by 5, 4 by 5, like that. Any point for different values of lambda in between 0 and 1, you can get coordinates of any point on this line. You can get coordinates of any point. Therefore, this is the methodology to find the coordinates of any point of the line. To get the coordinates of any point of the line. That's very, very important. Now, suppose if you take the equation of the plane in this form, if you take the equation of the plane in this form, ax plus by plus cz plus d is equal to 0, you take a point P, x1, y1, z1 on the plane. How do you take a point on the plane? See that it satisfies this equation. Like a conic. For a parabola, y square is equal to x is a parabola. Automatically, 1, 1 is a point. 1, 1 is a point. When x is 2, y square is 2, y is equal to root 2. Like that, you can get variable. By varying x, you can get y. So, various points can be obtained on the parabola. By giving x, we can get y. By giving y, we can get x. Like that. x1, y1, z1 is a point on this. Q, x2, y2, z2 is a point on this. You find coordinates of any point in between. You get a coordinate of any point in between. Automatically, it will satisfy this equation. If you take this point, then lambda is 1 by 5. You take lambda times x1, y1, z1 plus 1 minus lambda times x2, y2, z2. 1 minus lambda times x2, y2, z2. You allow lambda to vary from 0 to 1. You allow lambda to vary from 0 to 1. You get some point. That point will be in between P and Q. That point will satisfy this, provided these two ends, end points, satisfy the equation. Therefore, only by taking the equation of the plane like this, equation of the surface like this, the line joining any two points on the surface also lies on the surface. Also lies. That is, when all the points lie, the whole line lies. Therefore, only by taking the equation of the surface in the form ax plus by plus cz plus d is equal to 0, that definition satisfies. Which definition? The line joining any two points on the surface lies on the surface itself. Then that surface is called a plane. Once you take the equation in this form, that condition is satisfied. Therefore, we come to a conclusion. The general equation of a plane is this. Or any first degree equation. Any first degree equation in xyz, any first degree equation xyz will represent a plane. Will always represent a plane. So ax plus by plus cz plus d is equal to 0 represents a plane. We see the analogy. How it is analogous to a straight line? How it is analogous to a straight line? Let us see. We know in a straight line, ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Divide by c, you get a by c x, b by c y plus 1 is equal to 0. I am calling this as capital A, I am calling this as capital B, plus 1 is equal to 0. From 3 constants, I have reduced to 2 constants A and B. Once you know A and B, C is automatically obtained. Once A is known, A by C is known. B is known, B by C is known. Once A and B are known, automatically C is known. We can cross multiply and get A, B, C. Therefore, this equation of a straight line consists of two arbitrary constants, A and B. Therefore, to find the equation of a straight line, we require minimum two conditions. How many conditions we require to find the equation of a straight line? It is enough, you have 2 points. So, 1 point, 2 points. Join, you get a unique straight line. Therefore, because we are having only two constants in the equation of a straight line, this concept is extended for a plane, a surface, cone, cylinder, everything. This concept is extended. That is, in the equation of a plane, ax plus by plus cz plus d is equal to 0, divide by d, you get a by d x, b by d y, plus c by d z plus 1 is equal to 0. You call this as small a, you call this as small b, you call this as small c. Once A, B, C are known, D is known. Once D is known, complete the plane is known. So therefore, we are having only A, B, C. Three constants. We are having three arbitrary constants. Therefore, we require three conditions. We require three conditions to find the equation of a plane. Therefore, we will come to a conclusion. In general, ax plus by plus cz plus d is equal to 0 is a general equation of a plane, To find the equation of a plane, it's a flat surface, plane surface. Plane surface is called a plane, that's all. In this line joining, any 2 points will lie on the surface itself. To find the equation of a plane, unique plane, it is enough, you know three conditions. So once you know three conditions, we can find a unique plane. So therefore, from the arbitrary constants present, we simply say the equation of the plane consists of three arbitrary constants. That shows we require minimum three conditions to find the equation of the plane. We vary all the conditions. We'll vary all the conditions, we are getting different planes. We are discussing that in next class. So therefore, in general, we take this is the equation of a plane. This is a general story about a plane and is very interesting, very important also. With this, we develop the concepts of a plane. Thank you. Next class, we'll continue.